A new study shows online shopping in the Philippines has rapidly migrated from desktop computers to smartphones. That report by Malaysian firm iPrice has found mobile purchases in the country are now more than 2 times higher than those done on desktops. It says a similar trend is found in most Southeast Asian markets except Vietnam. The firm cited e-commerce providers' efforts to optimize their websites for smaller devices, such as through the development of mobile apps, for the growing trend. Well, as mobile purchases in the Philippines rise, a multi-commerce platform aims to take advantage of the growing trend by supporting non-retail small businesses in the country, hastening their digital shift. Chat Genie plans to do it with the help of the grant recently awarded by the MasterCard Strive community. For more on this, let's now talk with Rag De Falsis. He's the CEO, CTO, and co-founder of Chat Genie. Good morning, Rag De, and thank you so much for joining us.
Morning, Rain. Thanks for having me.
Now, you had 650 contestants, 8 winners. Chat Genie is the only one from the Philippines. The others from Cambodia, Brazil, Colombia, Nigeria, and Kenya. The goal of the MasterCard Innovation Fund is to build digital and data-first solutions that empower small businesses to thrive. What commitments in terms of product development and results did you have to make to be able to bag the prize?
First, not to think highly of ourselves, but the vision and objectives of the MasterCard Innovation Fund completely align with the vision that we have at Chat Genie. So Chat Genie was born out of a pandemic. And since then, I remember he interviewed me for the first time in 2020 about what we do. And we are consistent in building solutions that enable small and medium businesses to sell online. Ultimately, I think what led the team at MasterCard to choose us is to scale the impact of the things that we currently do to a broader segment of the business community.
Mm-hmm. Well, how much share of the $1 million do you receive? What budget did you seek from MasterCard?
So far, we got a total of $150,000 USD as a grant, which we will use to build innovations on top of our platform.
Mm-hmm. And what kind of timeline do you need to follow to deliver on commitments?
Since the projects that we propose to the MasterCard team are already part of the Chat Genie roadmap, we are already done with the pre-product development part of the process and now currently in the process of developing it. Hopefully, the solution will be available within this quarter.
And you're not allowed to speak of the 3 projects just yet?
The first project that we're looking to develop is basically allowing service-based businesses to use our solution to enable them to accept appointments and bookings inside the world's biggest apps.
Mm-hmm. Well, there are almost 1 million MSMEs in the Philippines, and you had been creating virtual storefronts, accommodating orders via messaging, and now enabling direct orders with payment systems. How many people do you have to be able to service all their digital sales solutions?
Since the public launch of our prototype last 2020, we are now close to reaching 4,000 businesses onboarded on our platform. This funding will not only allow us to pursue service-based businesses like what I said, but will also help businesses that are already on the platform to fully utilize the features that we built through a series of business incubation programs.
Mm-hmm. What do you think the funding might be able to afford for you? An interesting question in the MasterCard assessment was, can you pursue the projects without the funding?
As mentioned earlier, with or without the grant, the projects that we propose with MasterCard are already part of our product roadmap. MasterCard not only de-risked the development of those projects, but also validated through their panel of experts who are running the program.
Mm-hmm. All right, Rag De, with the funding, you want to expand their platform and make it more inclusive to non-retail e-commerce businesses and online retail brands that undertake manual order processing. First of all, you mentioned you already had 4,000 businesses with Chat Genie you're servicing now. How many more small businesses are you targeting?
Based on the data that we got, service-based businesses are around 6.55% of the overall registered merchants in the Philippines. That's actually around 65,000 businesses. We are targeting to have at least 5% of that in the next 12 months.
Okay, well, which non-retail e-commerce businesses could benefit from ChatGenie?
Currently, we already have solutions that allow businesses to sell inside the world's biggest apps like Messenger, Instagram, Viber, GCash, and soon TikTok. With this project supported by MasterCard, we can also allow businesses to accept bookings and appointments inside super apps. Typical service-based businesses are the likes of barbershops, salons, spa, skin clinics, pet grooming stations, etc.
All right. Well, you work not just with MSMEs, but also the big companies who have supported you all throughout the years. You have the likes of Globe, Microsoft, as well as the social media giants that you mentioned earlier. How much of the click-throughs through ChatGenie translate to sales for those brands and their websites? How much of your business is comprised of big firms and not just the MSMEs?
Actually, thanks for this question. No? Though our vision is to help small and medium businesses to sell inside super apps, we have big businesses like Globe Telecom that use our solution to accept mobile data plan applications on Messenger and GCash. They also use it to sell retail products under 917 brand. They also use it to basically get inquiries from their customers. No, pre and post ChatGenie, they experience over 500% increase in conversion rates. Another case study that we have is Vans Philippines. Right now, the Messenger store that they launched, powered by ChatGenie, now accounts to almost a third of sales on each store location.
Mm-hmm. Well, there are proposals to tax all digital transactions. May we know what your position is on this? Do you think that tax compliance can be effectively, number one, monitored and then actually insured so that the merchants are able to pay?
Well, in the context of small and medium businesses, that's a sensitive topic to discuss. Ultimately, if the government wants to go ahead with it and it will help raise funds to hasten our economic recovery, then we as an e-commerce platform have to comply with it. This might be off topic, but ChatGenie also won a competition in 2020 organized by the tax agency on building innovative solutions related to taxation. So definitely that's something that we'll support.
So it is you can actually monitor it. So this digitalization had been crucial during the start of the pandemic, and it seems it won't be slowing down. What kind of returns are you expecting as a company this year and next?
You're correct. The people that are used to buying online won't just stop because people can now, again, go out safely. Globally, there's a significant slowdown of growth in e-commerce. The growth that we experienced in 2020 was an anomaly. It might take 2 to 3 years to get that kind of volume again. Right now, people are going out more than they do pre-pandemic. No? If there's a revenge travel, there's revenge offline retail as well. But people are looking for innovative retail experience, which we are looking to incorporate of ChatGenie. When it comes to growth that we see in the company, it's definitely going to be sustainable growth, but it has to also include offline retail transactions, which is we're planning to add to our scope in the next few months as well.
Mm-hmm. But are you focusing more on local commerce, or are you tapping also, the regions?
Currently, the core market is still Philippines, especially in this global economic downturn. We're focusing our resources on basically to capture and dominate this space. But in the next few years, we're looking at targeting Singapore and Malaysia as our expansion markets.
All right. Rag DeFalce, CEO, CTO, and co-founder of ChatGenie. Congratulations, and thanks again for sharing your insights with us. We appreciate it.
Thanks again, Rain, for having me.